Welcome to Unity of Wilmington's Facebook Live experience for whatever time you're watching it. But if you're watching it live, it's Sunday morning in Wilmington, North Carolina. My name is Reverend Mindy Tucker, and I serve as co-minister along with Reverend Nickie Golden, who's giving the lesson today. But my first job is to welcome you into spiritual community, to welcome you into that online experience of being with other like-minded spiritual journeyers, people who are wondering and in a place of discovery, a consciousness of opening to have an experience of an expanded consciousness, to have a greater experience of love, joy, and peace, to have a healing in mind, body, and soul. Unity of Wilmington is part of a worldwide spiritual movement that builds consciousness. This very consciousness that I'm talking about, a consciousness of love, joy, and peace. It's a consciousness that begins in the heart of God, but from God's heart to your heart, God's heart to my heart, God's heart to everyone's heart. We soon have a greater community of like-minded individuals with hearts beating as one, knowing that there's only the kingdom of heaven, joy, love, and peace for us to experience and expand upon in this lifetime. Unity's been around for 130 years. Our co-founders, Myrtle and Charles Fillmore, had the idea of healing, the idea of transformation, and by focusing on the good and affirming the truth of us, the truth of our individual being, to have that healing, transformative experience. Charles Fillmore wrote, "The first step in all spiritual healing is to believe, and the next step is openness and receptivity to the stream of healing life. Through the exercise of faith and our words, the work is marvelously accomplished." And I'm reading from a little booklet called The Heart of Healing, which we're going to be looking at for the next 4 weeks. If you go to our website, unitywill.com, you'll see a link to get this booklet for free. Really, the words, the faith is what we've got. It's our natural faculty, everyone has faith, and we have all the faith that we are ever going to need. And the words we use are words of truth. I am a beloved expression of God. Those are words of truth. Each and every one of us is created in the image and likeness of God. I am a beloved expression of God. Would you say that with me, please? I am a beloved expression of God. The second truth that we affirm every time we come into spiritual community is that we're here for a holy purpose. It's about remembering that faith. It's about realigning our wayward thoughts, those thoughts that no longer serve our highest good, realigning them with words to the truth of who we are. I am here for a holy purpose, and so are you. You are here to shine your light. You are here to love. You are here to be that eye in the storm. You are here to remind others of their goodness, of their innate ability to heal themselves. You are indeed here for a holy purpose. So let's affirm that for ourselves, each and every one of us together. I am here for a holy purpose. And the third truth that we affirm every time we gather in spiritual community is that we're at the right place at the right time right now. We are where we are by divine appointment. So I am here at Unity of Wilmington, socially distanced, with the appropriate amount of people in the room by law. You are where you are by divine appointment. You are where you are in consciousness by divine appointment. You are in the right place at the right time right now. Let's make that affirmation together. I'm in the right place at the right time right now. We make all of these statements with integrity in unity, because we believe above and beyond all things that there's only one presence and one power, a presence and power we call God. So let's affirm unity's statement of being together as we come into a time of prayer. There is only one presence and one power, active in the universe and in my life, God the good omnipotence. Breathe out. Create space to breathe in with the infilling of spirit. That infilling of truth. That infilling of our divine nature. Prayer is time to set aside our cares and our worries, the inconsistencies, the divine discontent, and turn within. Turn within to the purity of life and love, of strength and wisdom, to zeal, to compassion, and indeed our holiness. For this union with the divine, for this reunion with the divine, we say thank you, God, and amen.
Through all the rain. My goodness, thank you, Samantha. That was wonderful. We totally appreciate that. Good morning, and at this time in the service, I'd like to welcome anyone who is here for the first time in our virtual space. It is great to have you with us. Coming together, even virtually, brings an energy to the service that's incredibly important. So thank you for showing up if it's your first time, if you're second or third time. Thank you and welcome back. And it's good to see you and be seen. We have a poem this morning, The One Desire, from our very own Stephanie Sharon. Can you allow yourself to really feel this spiraling galaxy that dances and celebrates itself, circling nothing, while the sun, bathed in fire, silently watches. Whether God is inhaling or exhaling, every particle is always as it was in the beginning. Do you have the courage to surrender to this kind of intimacy and only dance with God? Have you ever wanted anything else? If you hesitate even for a moment, go back to the task of burying your shadow. If not, abandon yourself to the center of God's breath.
As Mindy shared earlier, we're using the Unity booklet that's published regularly, and it's called The Heart of Healing. We're going to be doing this over the course of the next 4 weeks. And what we're going to look at today is the Heart of Healing opening. And I want to show you a picture of Myrtle Fillmore. The one on your left is, she's younger and then in her later times. When Myrtle Fillmore was young, she was diagnosed with tuberculosis, and it was thought that she wouldn't live very long. And one of the things that occurred was she and her husband, Charles Fillmore, Myrtle and Charles Fillmore, were the co-founders of the Unity Movement. They were looking for something that would help her to heal. They had been in this process for a long time. And one night, they walked into a meeting, a New Thought meeting, that was being led by E.B. Weeks. He had come down from Chicago to Kansas City, and he was doing this meeting, and they attended. And during the time that he was speaking, Myrtle Fillmore heard one phrase. You might know it. You might have heard it. Or it might be very new to you. And that phrase is this: I am a child of God. Therefore, I do not inherit sickness. I am a child of God. And therefore, I do not inherit sickness. Let's say that together. And I'm going to invite you to really let yourself feel it from your very toes, moving up through your body and out. Together, I am a child of God, and therefore I do not inherit sickness. Mrs. Fillmore went home that night, and across the next 2 years, this this event of hearing this word of truth, these affirmations of truth, this affirmation of truth, I am a child of God and I do not inherit sickness, happened in 1886. Mrs. Fillmore went home. She began to bless all the organs of her body. She began to thank them for their service to her. She began to ask forgiveness for any time that she had thought them less than whole. And she was tenacious in this. Mrs. Fillmore did this across 2 years. Take a breath to that and think. Would you be willing to open to healing in such a way that you focus on the process for 2 years? Think about that for a moment. I don't know if you're anything like me, but I might start thinking, nothing's happening. Maybe I'm not doing it right. Do you have any of those thoughts? But Mrs. Fillmore was tenacious. Every single day and every hour of the day, she prayed and she asked the energy of life, life force, intelligent life, to move in through and as her, through her body. Stopping to reflect, but most of all, stopping to remember who she was. In her own words, Mrs. Fillmore says, I went to all the life centers of my body and I spoke words of truth, words of strength and power. We speak affirmations such as, I am a child of God and therefore I do not inherit sickness. We speak those words not to make them true, but we speak them because they are true. We are created in the image of and the likeness of God. In God is wholeness. Thus within us is all wholeness. We have that same capacity for wholeness. Russell Lake, a Unity writer, says if even one person can experience healing, then all people have that capacity, because that capacity comes from our divine nature, and each and every one of us has that divine nature within us and are called to express that divine nature as much as we can, moment by moment throughout our days. And Myrtle Fillmore, across 2 years, healed. Which is why I wanted to show you a picture of her young and a picture of her later on in her life. She died at the age of 86. So between 1886 and 1888, Mrs. Fillmore consistently, regularly, tenaciously focused on her healing, and healing happened. And if it can happen for one of us, it can happen for all. Martha Smock says it this way: the healing you long for does not come as a result of your frantic prayers. It comes naturally and easily as you let the healing power of God flow in and through you. As we open to that healing power, and as we open from an inner knowing of life's intelligence flowing in through and as us, we open from that knowingness of our divine nature. We open from that knowingness that it is possible. Even when our thoughts sometimes tell us it is not, our heart opening can tell us and show us that it is possible. I want to share another story of healing with you. This is a story from the Gospel of Mark. The writer of Mark is one of the gospel writers that would drop in a few times, Jesus speaking in his own Aramaic language, the language that he was used to speaking. You may remember that the gospels were predominantly written in Greek and then translated from Greek to English. Jesus was in this area that sometimes you'll see written as the Ten Cities. It's called Decapolis. It's between Tyre and Sidon, and he was there with his disciples teaching. He was there with his disciples, and he had gone into some of the synagogues that are there, although this was predominantly a non-Jewish area. It would be the area that we would think of as Lebanon these days. And through his teaching, Jesus had developed a reputation as a healer. One of the things that distinguished Jesus' teachings from other people is that if a man goes to synagogue, that they know that they could be called upon to share the information about the lesson that was being taught that day. And one of the things that distinguished Jesus from other men was that he spoke from his own authority. And so you can imagine that at times this caused people to really question him. But when he was questioned by the Pharisees, when he was questioned by the rabbis, when he was questioned by the religious leaders, he opened his heart, turned within, and answered from his own authority. So people flocked to him. They saw something different in him. And one day, as he was moving through this area, a group of people came to him, and they brought a man who was deaf and could not speak. Sometimes it's called deaf and dumb. And you'll find this story in the 7th chapter of Mark, verses 31 to 37. So the people brought this man to Jesus, and Jesus took him and he took him aside. He took him apart from the crowd. And he looked at him, and he took both of his fingers and put them in his ears and held them for a moment. And then he spat, and you might think that's a little gross. I do. But in that culture, saliva was thought to be healing. So Jesus spat, and then Jesus touched the man's tongue. And he puts his hands back in his ears, and he looks upward, and he says the word "Ephphatha." And Mark translates it for us from the Aramaic to the Greek and then to the English, "Ephphatha." And what "Ephphatha" means is it means be opened. We must be open to healing for healing to occur. And the man had been brought to Jesus, and the man stepped aside with Jesus, and Jesus placed his hands and called the openness out of him. What that suggests is the openness, that possibility for healing, was already present in the man. And healing happened. The man began to hear, and the man began to speak. And Jesus said to the man, "Don't tell anybody." This was frequent with Jesus, "Don't tell anybody." But what do you think happens? I don't know really what Jesus' purpose is, but in modern day times, quite often when you say, "Don't tell anybody," that's the very thing that happens. And that's exactly what happened in that day and age. The man went and he shared with people. And people who encountered the man were surprised. What happened? How can you suddenly speak and how can you hear? And he shared his story. And he shared about his opening. The Bible often does parallelisms, and the prophet Isaiah talked about those who have ears to hear will hear, and those who are deaf will begin to speak. And so Mark was also bringing forth the teachings that Jesus had learned in the synagogues. Those who have ears to hear will hear. And those who are deaf and those who are dumb will begin to speak. Opening. An opening from one culture to another culture. An opening that is the reason that Myrtle Fillmore could take that affirmation, "I am a child of God, therefore I do not inherit sickness," and tune in to the opening inside of her, to the capacity inside of her, because we all have all of the capacities of God in every moment. The question is, are we living from that consciousness? Are we living from those capacities? And she was willing to live from those capacities, to live in that potentiality till it became a reality. Moment by moment, day by day, Jesus knew beyond a shadow of a doubt, so he could hold his hands over that man's ears and call them to open, call the man's heart to open. So I'm going to invite you for a moment to think about, what are some ways that you have shut down your heart? The heart is that place that we send love to each other. What kind of layers are upon your heart that keep that radiant God-like energy, that radiant life force energy, that intelligent radiant life energy moving out of you, so that it moves between us, so that it moves from my heart to your heart, and your heart to another's heart, and to another's heart, so that we can begin to know beyond a shadow of a doubt that we have the same capacity of the man who is deaf, who could hear. We have the same capacity as Myrtle Fillmore to heal. Do we have the tenacity? Do we have the stick-to-itiveness of it? Do we have the desire and the knowing that that opening can happen for us in an instant? Something to truly reflect upon. Something to be with. I want to share another story with you. There's a physician, her name is Diane Raymond. She's an unusual and unique physician because when people come to her, she uses art, she uses music, she uses sound, she uses and invites people into their own creativity for the process of healing. It's a form of opening. And one day, a young man who was 24 years old came to her. His leg had been amputated at his hip due to bone cancer. It was the only way the doctors felt that they could save his life. And as you might imagine, he came in angry, and he came in hurt. And he came in with this experience of rage whenever he saw somebody who had two legs or who were healthy. But he was open enough to come in. And she worked with him across several years. It took many years for him to release and let go of the rage that he felt. He did it through dancing. He did it through painting. He did it through journaling. He did it through writing. And he did it. That's the thing to remember. Across those years, he did it. And what he found is, as his heart opened up, that he had greater compassion for other people. That he would look at somebody who was struggling with health, and his heart would open up. And we know from current science that when our heart opens up and we come into heart coherence, that we have an internal knowingness of our own wholeness. And the very same thing happened for this young man. When his heart opened and he went into heart coherence, he had a compassion and a love, not only for himself, but for other people. So he began, little by little, to start to visit people in the hospitals who were struggling. And one day he came into this young woman's hospital room with permission. And she was mad and she was angry and she was sullen, and she would not talk to him. And he spent time with her. And the nurses had on music so that they were hoping that the music would help her to sing, to open up her heart, to begin to open to that process of healing. And he came back week after week. And one day, as the music was playing, he got this idea. So he took his leg off and he started dancing around the room to the music with that one leg, holding his one leg, his prosthesis up, and dancing on his good leg, hopping around and dancing and twirling and just having a delightful time. And she began to laugh. The young woman began to laugh. And what she said to him was, "If you can dance, then I can sing." And from that point on, they could sing and dance together. Opening, a willingness to open our hearts, a willingness to let that intelligent life force energy flow through us. Myrtle Fillmore says, the moment a person yields his self to godlikeness, and I apologize for the his, but this is the time in which Myrtle Fillmore wrote, the moment a person yields to his self to godlikeness, he is letting the Spirit of God burst the shell of doubt and fear, and the light of faith reveals to him the light of life. He becomes conscious of the joy in life in himself and in everybody else. And that's exactly what this young man did for this young woman. They burst that shell of doubt and let the life force energy that is natural to us because of our who we are, because of our divine nature, to simply flow. No frantic prayers needed to allow that life force energy to open the layer after layer after layer of pain that sometimes closes our hearts, to open to the joy that is natural for us, to allow ourselves to live in the fullest expression of who we are, to love generously, and to be all that we were called to be on this planet, to be that place where God shows up for ourselves and for each other, for our community, to radiate life, to radiate the joy of life, and to know beyond the shadow of a doubt that we are divine. Myrtle Fillmore says, did I skip one? Whoops, sorry you guys. I missed the slide. I open my heart to divine nature, the Spirit of God within. I burst that shell of doubt. So we must learn to take this on, to fulfill it, to embody it, to live it. I open my heart to my divine nature, the Spirit of God within. I burst the shell of doubt and fear and open to the light of faith, revealing the light of life. I become conscious of the joy of life in myself and everyone else. I'm opening my heart to healing. Are you willing to burst that shell of doubt and fear? To be tenacious in your healing, to be open to the very heart of healing, and to know that in opening, in staying with it, in living your God-like self, that healing is yours. And it begins in this moment and continues moment by moment by speaking words of truth, by knowing who you are, and by living from that consciousness. Let's say these words together. We'll take it slow because we're all spread out. But let's say these words together. And I'm going to ask you to place your hand on your heart, because the moment we place our hands on our hearts, where we place our attention is where we place our energy. So when we place our hands on our heart, we are engaging in the very first of this moment's process of opening. The heart of healing, opening to our own divinity, opening to the life that flows through us, opening to love. Together, I open my heart to my divine nature, the Spirit of God within. I burst the shell of doubt and fear, and I open to the light of faith, revealing the light of life. I become conscious of the joy of life in myself and everyone else. I am opening my heart to healing. Are you willing to open your heart to healing? Let's begin to take this process, these thoughts, these ideas, into a time of meditation, into a time of opening, into a time of, even if it's just in this moment, being willing. Be opened. The words of the Master Teacher Jesus. Be opened. And then as we embody those words, I am opening. I am opening. Coming into a time of meditation, a time of reflection. Beginning to focus our awareness, our attention on our hearts. Beginning that process from this moment on, a choosing, a conscious choosing of opening, of becoming all that we can, of recognizing our God-likeness, as Mrs. Fillmore said. A time focused and centered on ourselves, a willingness to be tenacious, to have the desire to heal, that we are only willing to know that that healing is possible. To speak the words of truth to our organs. To turn within to the presence of God that we are, allowing it to expand, to open our hearts, to expand past our hearts, to come out to the very edges of our body, to circulate that energy through our breath, allowing a vetha to open, holding the knowing, releasing the fear and the doubt, and standing in the truth of our being. We are created in the image of and as the likeness of God. We are divine. We are one. One with the one who created us. We are whole, perfect, and complete. Now allowing ourselves to focus so much on that wholeness, that is all that we see. That in the midst of what feels like the end, what feels like the chaos, what feels like the crisis, like the young man, we can begin to paint, to journal, to sing, to dance, one or two-legged. We begin to learn to allow that life force energy that we are to radiate forth from us, as us, opening our hearts to ourselves, focusing love on ourselves, and allowing that love to radiate out to others. We'll take a moment in the sacred and holy silence. I am opening to healing. Say it quietly with me. I am opening to healing. And say it a little bit louder. Breathing in the very essence of that statement of truth. I am opening to healing. I am opening to healing. The disciples were an interesting crew. They followed Jesus around day by day. They listened to his teachings. And sometimes they still were like, what? I don't understand it. What are you doing? What are you saying? And so one day they came to him and they said, Teacher, teach us to pray. And what came out of that question of theirs to Jesus was what we know as the Lord's Prayer. Here we say it translated from the Aramaic to the English. So as we open our hearts, as we open our minds, as we open our lives to the indwelling Spirit that is within us, let's pray this prayer out loud together. Father, Mother, birther, and breath of all, create a space inside us and fill us with your presence. Let oneness now prevail. Your one desire then flows through ours as energy fills all forms. Give us each day our physical and spiritual peace. Untangle the knots of error that bind us as we release others. Don't let appearances make us forgetful of the source, but free us to act appropriately. From you, age to age, flow the glorious harmonies of life. May these statements be fertile ground from which our future grows. Amen and amen. Amen and amen and amen, which means so be it. So be it, so be it, so be it. We're at the time of our service where the very first thing I want to do is thank you for your generosity, for your giving. Thank you for your love, for the beautiful notes that we get when you send in a check. I want to share with you that there are ways to give here. Our giving, let it come from your heart. Let it come from the joy of life. Let it come from your very essence as you allow yourself to engage in the law of circulation. Let it be what it is. Let it be enough. And let it be from joy. So there's several ways here. You can mail a check in. You can go to our website. Way down at the bottom, there's a donate button. You can do PayPal. So there are several ways to engage in that law of circulation. And we give thanks in advance for all of the ways that you are feeling touched, moved, and inspired to give. Let's say our affirmation. Divine love through me blesses and multiplies all that I am, all that I give, and all that I receive, and so it is.
After all my strength is gone, in you
absolutely phenomenal. With gratitude, we receive your blessings, and together we say, as I demonstrate grateful giving, I am an open channel through which prosperity flows. I am blessed. Unity of Wilmington is blessed. The world is blessed. Thank you, thank you, thank you, God. Well, we do follow the Daily Word, which is published by Unity World Headquarters in Lee Summit, Missouri. It goes all around the world, translated into something like 9 languages. If you are in the Wilmington area and want to purchase a hard copy, give us a call, set up a time. Our admin, Wendy Miller, will be here for you, ready to $3. It's a deal. But today's daily word is let go and let God. The affirmation is, I let go and trust the divine in me. I let go and trust the divine in me. Would you say that together? I let go and trust the divine in me. Almost makes me feel a little bit like a superhero, Bruce Kenny.
Excellent. How good is that? And we have a couple of more announcements today. Today at noon, there's the community connection. Show up for the Zoom meeting. There's information on the meeting ID right there. No registration is required. It'll be at noon.
Right. About half an hour. We have a weekly email, and the information is in the weekly email. If you want to get on our mailing list, go to Unity of Wilmington, hit the Connect page, and you can fill it out and subscribe that way. If you are not sure you want to get the email or you missed it, go to our events page, and the information is there. It's also on the homepage in the news section. It's just a time for fun. Just like if we had church here, now we're going to go in the community room and have connection.
Nice. Very good. Very good.
Unity Center of Peace in Chapel Hill is offering the official Unity prayer class. This prayer class is being taught by Reverend Linda Martella-Witsett, who is the head of Silent Unity. She doesn't teach very often. This is a huge deal. If you want to have Unity prayer class, it's in a format that's Friday night, all day Saturday, and part of Sunday. You can still go to your respective Facebook Lives things, but it's $85. Be with the master, and think about it. It's online. You can do this.
Excellent. And from our Sacred Space Committee, we have Nurturing Life. And we've got a quote today from Eckhart Tolle. Acknowledging the good that you already have in your life is the foundation for all abundance.
And we define abundance in a number of ways. So what are some of the ways?
Oh my goodness. Abundance is the feeling that all things are possible.
Abundance is an abundance of green in the spring leaves.
Abundance of green in the spring leaves. Abundance of green in your wallet. Abundance of
love in your life.
Love in your life. For me, abundance includes a kale patch in my backyard. And anytime I want vegetables, it's out there.
I've been craving kale this week.
I've been eating kale this week.
So Rapunzel, yeah, I'm going to envy your garden. Oh, let's see. Prayer requests. If you would like us to support you in your opening, we have a number of ways to connect in prayer on our website. There's a prayer tab on our homepage, and you can email your prayer in. You can call the office, leave a message. We'll call you back. You can email RevNickieGolden@gmail.com. You can go to Silent Unity. Know that you are not alone on your spiritual journey. Mm.
And this is a time in our spiritual journey where we hold children that are children and children within, with a blessing. So envision our children or see them in real life. And children,
we love you, we bless you, we appreciate you, and we behold the Christ you are. Let's have our prayer for protection. The light of God surrounds us, the love of God. Let's start again.
Rewind.
The light of God surrounds us. I am light. The love of God enfolds us. I am love. The power of God protects us. I am power. The presence of God watches over us. I am presence.
Wherever we are, God is. I am divine.
And from that consciousness of divinity, I invite you to continue to open your hearts this week, to think about opening your hearts, to place your attention on your heart, for that is where your energy will be, and allow the healing, the wholeness that is you, to simply come forward. No need for frantic prayer, as Martha Smock says, just simply being in the flow of intelligent life. And have the best time you can doing it. Have a great week. Thank you. Much love to each and every one of you.